Children, as we all know, we are all living things. And around us, we can see many living organisms, including plants, insects, animals, and many more. In today's lesson, we are going to talk about plants. We are going to know about plants and their different functions of their parts. As we have many different parts in our body, in the same way, they also have different parts and all of them are assigned particular work. Let's find out what are the objectives in this chapter. In this chapter, we are going to identify different types of plants, list the parts of a plant, identify different types of root, list the function of roots. We are going to learn about the function of the stems as well. If you will visit a garden or forest, you will be able to differentiate different types of plants around you. Some of them are short, some of them are large, some of them stems are soft and some of their stems are hard. According to the types of that appearance, we can differentiate the plants into many categories like shrubs, tree, creepers, herb, etc. There are climbers as well. Different parts of plant serve different purposes. Like the function of the roots are, root is the underground non-green part of a plant body. Root perform two main functions. They absorb water from the soil, as we already know about it, and also they anchor the plant firmly in the soil. We can perform an activity to understand the importance of root. We will be going to perform this activity in our class. We have to take two plants and we will remove one root from plant B and then we will observe what will happen. Look at this picture. After a few days, the plant which does not have the root, it will die. And also, we can be able to easily pluck out the plant B. But in case of plant A, if we try to pull it, then we will not be able to pull that plant A that easily. Because of course, it has roots, which is holding the soil firmly. But in case of plant B, we can easily remove the plant from the soil, because it doesn't have the root. As we all know, there are two types of root, mainly taproot and fibrous root. Radish, carrot, etc. You all know about it. And what are the examples of fibrous root? Maize crop, wheat crop, rice, etc. Let us talk about the stem. Stem has different parts on it. They are node and internode. Now, what are they? Node is a point of attachment of a leaf or a twig on the stem in the plant. That means from where the branch or the twig or a leaf can originate. Now, what is the internode? The area between two nodes is known as internode. What is their function? They can carry the water through the entire body of the plant and also they are the growth zone of the plant. They provide them the structural support as well. In this chapter, there will be many activities which we are going to perform in the class. Our next topics are structure of a leaf, transpiration, photosynthesis, and understanding the structure of a flower. As we all know that the leaves and the stem together form the shoot, the part of leaf by which it is attached to the stem is called petiole. The broad green part of a leaf is called the lamina. You already know about this from class 5th. Small lines present on a leaf are called veins. These give support and transport water and mineral through the leaves. A thick vein in the middle is known as midrib. And remember, the arrangement of vein on the leaf is called venation. So we can also say it like that, the design made by veins in the leaf is called the leaf venation. If the design is net-like on both sides of mid-rib, it is called reticular venation. On rose plant or coriander plants, we can be able to see this kind of reticular venation. And if the design made by vein is parallel to one another in a leaf is called parallel venation. You can be able to observe in case of grass, wheat and maize plant leaf, etc. Next is transpiration. It is through transpiration that plants keep themselves cool in the summer season. What is the definition of transpiration? The process by which water vapor evaporates from the leaves and stems of a plant into the atmosphere. That particular process is known as transpiration. And from the stomata of the leaf, the transpiration process can occur. Our next topic is photosynthesis. We all know about the process of photosynthesis. We are learning the photosynthesis process from class 2. So, plants make their own food by the process of photosynthesis. We all know about it. Let's learn again the definition of photosynthesis. It is a process by which leaves of a plant use the energy from the sunlight to convert the carbon dioxide from the air, and the water is absorbed from the soil into glucose. And this glucose is the source of their energy that they store in the form of starch. The tiny structures on leaves inside which photosynthesis takes place are known as chloroplast. A chloroplast will look like this. These are the microscopic structures you cannot able to see with your naked eye. These chloroplasts are also known as the food factories. Chlorophyll is a pigment which is responsible for the green color of the leaves. Next is flower. Flower is mainly the reproductive part of a plant. Due to different colors of flower, we are able to recognize the plant. Different parts of flowers are petals, sepals, pistil and stamen. There are also other parts as well. Like the outer part of the flower is known as calyx. It consists of green leaf-like sepals. Next is corolla. The inner part of the flower is known as corolla. It comprises the petals. Due to the different colors of the petal, it can attract the insects, which will further help in the pollination process. The male part of the flower is called the stamen. It has two parts. They are filament. The green structure that you can see here is known as the filament, and the yellowish portion is known as the anther. If we will cut the anther into two parts, we can be able to see this kind of structure. They are known as the pollen sac, and pollen are stored inside it. The female part of the flower is called the pistil. It is the innermost part of a flower. It has three parts. First is stigma. Next, the upper part receives pollen grain for fertilization. Second is style, a long hollow tube-like structure joined stigma and the ovary. And the third is ovary, in which ovules are produced. The mature ovary develops into fruit, and the mature ovules will develop into seeds. So children, read this chapter very carefully. Next day, we are going to discuss about the doubts. Thank you.